We have not yet seen the kind of protests that we saw in late winter here, but certainly the groups that are opposed to this collective bargaining going through are rallying the troops right now, trying to get them here at least for tomorrow.
Yeah, that's true. We did see a number of rallies throughout the day today, but nothing like what is expected here tomorrow. It may be similar, although probably not as large in number as we saw earlier this year. All sides agree on that. The state's largest teachers union is among those encouraging its members to participate in the rallies here at the Capitol tomorrow. They will turn out, and when they do, the ralliers, the protesters here, will find a different set of rules in place this time around. The scene was familiar and the chants similar, only the location changed. Today, a crowd of protesters marched from the Capitol several blocks to the offices of the business group Wisconsin Manufacturers and Commerce, a major supporter of Governor Walker.
Governor Walker has said there needs to be a shared sacrifice, but right now what we're seeing is the middle class is having to sacrifice and corporations are sharing in our tax dollars.
Even before the marchers made their way here, some people had marked the building with signs of the protest. There was a heavy police presence here, but not nearly as big as the one that will greet protesters inside the Capitol tomorrow.
We are prepared to work closely with these different groups, but at the same time, everyone's expected to follow the rules and the laws of the state and the rules and laws of the Capitol.
While it's been a smaller group of protesters that's kept a steady vigil outside in what they call Walkerville, both Capitol Police and rally organizers say they expect a large turnout for the start of the budget talks.
It is absolutely essential for the people to make their voices be heard.
But while their voices may be heard, there's something that won't be. Drums and noisemakers of any kind are now off limits inside the Capitol. Late today, protesters sounded horns outside the governor's office, but that's a scene and a sound that will no longer be allowed inside the building. Four entrances will be open here at the Capitol, but everyone going inside will have to pass through security checkpoints. And in addition to that ban on noisemakers, they also won't be allowing any signs on sticks or any signs or anything else for that matter taped to the walls here inside the Capitol. And they also won't be allowing any pillows or sleeping bags. People will be allowed to stay inside as long as the lawmakers are at work. That could be through the night. But they won't be camping out here inside the Capitol anymore. Reporting live from Madison, I'm Kent Wainscott, WISN 12 News.